Good evening, welcome to dotprogramming.blogspot.com. Today I will show you ASP.NET MVC drop-down list selected index change example. I mean to say when we select, or you can say change index of the drop-down list, then event occurs that selected index change. Actually that event is not available in ASP.NET MVC, but event is available in web form. So if you are a web form user and you want to move from web form to the MVC, then you can do by this techniques. Actually this technology is used to jQuery or also you can call partially, that is also provided, or you can say I uploaded video on YouTube in this channel. So first of all, this is the binded list from the database that is already uploaded video in my channel. So the first primary task is to load some data into the database, drop-down list by using database table or the select list items. So the next thing I will do here, that is get the item from the drop down list, that is multiple items. You can also add multiple items, that I mean to say that concat one item with the other items, okay, and also get a single item at a time. So you do you can do this by using the jQuery change method, okay. So here we have a simple method document.ready. In the ready we have a function, okay. Now add a variable a, not necessary for here to create a variable. First of all, get a ID selector and in which we can call the change method, because I want to change the index actually. So change, so remove this and call the change method function. Yeah, again so get the text on a variable from the drop down list. So fruit list dot fruit list space options colon selected dot text, and that variable value get using span tag, that is ID is span 1 dot text is a, okay. So thank you very much to get the item for this watching this video tutorial. To get the item at a time single, okay. If you want to get multiple items at a time, that is to take a list box in place of the drop down list, okay. So you can check that list of items multiple. Now show the previous value, previous get value, then you can concat, then you must to concat that value of the span tag. Now save this and run it. So thank you very much for watching this video tutorials. Please keep watching my all other video tutorials which is related to ASP.NET MVC. Thank you very much.